Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic molecular basis of inheritance. So let's see the requirements to fulfill the genetic material, or what are necessary things that a material should have to transmit the characters. Now, the genotype function or their application is the first function which is performed, or you can say it is undergoing by the genetic material. So the genetic material must be capable of storing genetic information and transmitting this information faithfully from parents to progeny or generation after generation. So genotype, first of all, what it means? It is the genetic makeup which decides the character, okay? That means whatever character is there of a organism, it is decided by the genes, or you can say the specific genetic material. Okay, so that is a genotypic function. And phenotypic function, or you can say the gene expression, the genetic material must control the development of phenotype of organism. It may be virus, bacteria, or plant or animal. Phenotype means the externally visible character of an organism. Example, for this you can say tall or short plants. And for the genotype, the example can be pure tall, hybrid tall, or pure short, like this. So that is, the genetic material must dictate the growth or differentiation of an organism from single cell zygote to the mature adult. Now when the plant grows, if it becomes pure tall, so what happens? The specific genes from the pure tall plant gets transmitted to the next generation, and like this, that plant also grows in a total, or you can say pure tall form. So that is the main thing which is transmitted from the genes from one generation to another generation. This means the genetic material decides the growth, or you can say the differentiation of an organism. Now chromosomes are considered composed of two types of large organic molecules, which are also called as macromolecules. First is proteins and second is nucleic acids. There are basically two types of nucleic acid, DNA and RNA. Deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid. Now for many years there was considerable disagreement among the scientists as to which these molecules carries the genetic information. But during 1940s and early 50s, several elegant experiments were carried out that clearly shows that the nucleic acid is a genetic material rather than the protein. So nucleic acid mainly carries that genetic material which is responsible for transmission of characters from one generation to other. Now more specifically, these experiments showed that DNA from nucleic acid, there are two types of nucleic acid. First is DNA and RNA. From that, DNA is a genetic material for all living organisms except for RNA viruses, which carries the genetic material. Okay, DNA is act as a genetic material in all the organisms, while in the viruses, RNA acts, in some viruses RNA acts as genetic material. So students, in this session we have seen the requirements which fulfill the molecules as a genetic material. Thank you.